Showed us that we could. Coming back towards us, look how slim she is when she comes towards you. A very small radar signature for a big aeroplane. Spiral climb coming up. And the wheels coming down as she starts her descent from the spiral climb. 18 wheels, 16 in the main undercarriage, 2 in the nose. So you'll see her come by with the undercarriage down. Might even be able to pick out some of the lettering on the undercarriage doors if you're close enough. Interesting when you look at the size, she's about the same size as a not very big Airbus airliner. Lovely little howl there. So just on the undercarriage door, the far side, you see the Airbus. And yet she can just tiptoe away like that. This way before, but what I expect to see now is that as she comes past in front of us, we'll see the bomb bay open. This is the weapons bay that carried 21,000 pounds of conventional bombs, 21,000 pound bombs. And when we heard, as we heard this morning from Martin Withers, they flew that more than 7,000 miles down to the Falkland Islands and back from Ascension Island. That's as far as going non-stop from here to Bali in the days long before that was ever thought of. Watch for the bomb doors opening. There they are. Because, of course, in 1982, towards the end of her operational career, and supported by 11 Victor tankers and one other Vulcan. Vulcan 607 hit the centre line of Port Stanley runway at the Falkland Islands with one bomb, and they hit the edge of the runway with another, which made it unusable for the Argentine fast jets. And until the Gulf War came along, it was the longest bombing raid in history, and it took no less than 18 air-to-air refuelings. Now, the bomb bay is still open, as you come back in front of us, I think we'll see it closing. The AEO's job, there's a periscope to check that all is well under the aircraft. There's it closes the huge bomb bay. I mean, 21 1,000-pound bombs takes up an awful lot of space. Had your name inside the bomb bay. It is absolutely full of the names of people who've contributed money for that purpose. Much of the fundraising is done by the Vulcan to the Sky Club, has more than 8,000 members. One of the biggest aviation heritage support clubs in the world. They're running the Vulcan mini village here, off to the right of the control tower. If you're looking at the airfield, do go and see them when Vulcan's gone. Now, I think this may be her last pass. I'm not quite sure. Display. What a lovely sight on this gorgeous summer's day at Royal Air Force Cosford. And many thanks to Vulcan to the Sky Trust for bringing her over here. Please do go and see the people at the mini Vulcan.